Hi, it's Kelowna here, if there's anyone that I have not met. I am really excited to be here with you guys tonight. It's tonight here, depending on what time zone you're in and where you're going to be watching, or if you're coming back to watch later. This is our winter wellness workshop. So thank you for joining me. We're hanging out in my kitchen tonight. So I have a lot of really exciting information for you guys. And if you have any friends that are in this community education group, feel free to tag them, like type their name in. And so the video is not shareable because it's a private Facebook group. So if you tried to like share it to your Facebook page, only people who were in this group would see it. But if you have anyone that wants to be here, tag them so that they can see that we're live, because it's fun to have everybody on live. So say hi when you guys come in, maybe share where you're watching from. It's always, hi Pam, I see Pam, I see Kylie. Good to see you guys. So it's fun to see where everybody is watching from. And I'm gonna jump right in and get started after you guys tag a friend, and people can come back and watch later if they want to. So I wanted to talk about winter wellness because as the seasons change, it's super important for us to make changes within our diet, within our supplements, with what oils we're using, and just different daily practices to keep our bodies balanced. And you'll probably notice that, well, raise your hand or comment below, even if you're watching the replay later or if you're here now, just comment below if you've noticed that when the seasons change, you notice that you get sick or people in your life get sick. Like, have you ever noticed that? If it gets super hot or if it gets super cold or if it gets really stormy and rainy all of a sudden, or if there's crazy Santa Ana winds like here in Southern California, like notice what happens in your body. Like sometimes we easily flow with it and other times it's like that's when we get sick, right? Like, I don't know, I know for me, I notice that, or even things like a full moon or a new moon or Mercury in retrograde or even planetary things have an effect on our bodies. So the more we can be in tune with how to adapt with these changes and what we can do to keep ourselves balanced and healthy and strong, then the healthier we can be. Now, my disclaimer, nothing I'm sharing is intended to prevent, diagnose, cure or substitute for going to a doctor. So I'm gonna share information that I have researched or things that I've learned that I find helpful for me, and I'm just sharing that with you. So always take it with a grain of salt, you know, take what feels good to you and apply it to your life or share with people that you know. And I hope that some of this resonates with you and that you'll find it really helpful. But I know that sometimes you might have a specific illness or issue that you're being taken care of by a doctor for, and so you might not be able to make changes, you know, like these. But anyway, that's my disclaimer. Always tune in to yourself, number one, whenever you are making any changes to your health regimen. So I believe, and from what I've read, when we get sick or when the weather changes, we have an opportunity to grow and change. So when we have an opportunity, sometimes when we get sick or get injured, we get kind of wiped out and we're laid up, it's an opportunity for us to go within and figure out what changes we need to make to bring our bodies back into balance. So I that's why I love working with the emotions, and that's gonna be part of this tonight. We're gonna talk a little bit about that. So it's an invitation for us to change, and it's something that we can grow from. And it's not always, you know, getting sick. Sometimes just feeling a little bit off. You know that you need to make a change, but you're not sure what it is. So tuning in is the first step. And ancient wisdom says that change is the only truth in the universe, right? So there's nothing permanent except change. Everything is always changing. The weather is always changing. I talked about different patterns that affect us, like the new moon and the full moon. Even day and night, we have different needs during those times, right? And then the seasons. So internally, we have cycles like biological clocks. And so we have those biological clocks regulate our hormones, our metabolism, our menstrual cycles, how much we grow in childhood, when we hit puberty and, you know, adolescence, and when we go through menopause. Like, those are all kind of these internal biological clocks, right? And other internal cycles reflected, you know, in our, are reflected in our emotional patterns and our mental state and even our spiritual connection. It's all interwoven, right? So body, mind, all of the emotions, mental, spiritual, it's all, I believe that it's all connected. And that's why I like to focus on holistic health. It's working with the whole body, not just compartmentalizing or trying to make symptoms go away. It's like, how can we find balance in the whole being, the whole person? So an important key to taking care of ourselves or our health is being aware of what's going on within us and what's going on out here. So that's why we're talking about these outer cycles, like what's going on with the weather, and then what's happening within us, where we are, what stage of life we're in, and what could be happening within us. So when we resist change, that's when we're more liable to be susceptible to illness and things like that. So ideally, we want to keep our bodies in a relaxed and open state so that energy can flow and we can adapt to these different changes as they happen. That's ideal, right? So let's talk about winter. Who's feeling, raise your hand, if you are feeling more emotional these days? Anyone feeling more emotional as we move into winter? So we're not actually in winter yet, right? We're still in fall, but that's why we're doing this now, because we're gonna be moving into winter. And sometimes we can feel more emotional in winter. So just being aware of that, because winter is a more inward and just a more sensitive time where Mother Nature is kind of in her resting season, right? So it's quiet, more withdrawn, kind of thinking about earth and its roots. It's a time to pay attention to our root chakra. So we've done classes, I did a series in here, and they were also shared on the YouTube channel, of chakra balancing with crystals and essential oils, right? And we talked about all different things to balance different chakras. This is a season that we would more focus on the lower chakras, specifically the root. So you can think about the roots and the earth and all of that energy is what we're kind of tapping into, and that prepares us for spring, the next season. So you might notice being kind of deeper within yourself, needing more replenishment, needing to be resting more often, kind of going inside and reflecting. It's a good time to journal and just be aware of your senses. That's what winter is all about. And then the winter climates, right? We have snow, I mean, depending on where you live. So if you're in Australia, you have to like reverse this, right? Because they're in their summer. But in most places, I would say, on this side of the world at least, we have snow, we have wet weather, like rain and more fog and things like that. And so we get cold, right? We can get chilled to the bone. I mean, I surf still in the winter and the water temperature drops and I'm still out there. Sometimes I have to wear, like, I wear a hood now to keep warm on top of my wetsuit, just so that I can be out there because I love being in the water. But anyway, we definitely need to focus on keeping our body warmer, even though it's cooler. So we spend more time at home naturally. We're seeking inner warmth and kind of more that nurturing and being home. So that's something to be aware of. Then on the 21st, we have the winter solstice, right? So after that, the days start getting longer all the way until summer. So that's kind of like the shortest day of the year, right? The longest night, first day of winter. So winter seems to be a time where we really want to keep our body warm. So that's one thing to go back to when you think about staying healthy this season is, how can I be warm? And we're gonna talk about several different ideas for staying warm. And you might think of a couple things also if you wanna comment and chime in. I am like more than happy to have you guys going back and forth and giving, you know, things that you do or things that resonate with you. I love like the interaction, and so does everybody else. So be interactive on here as much as you want in the comments. I love that. So we're talking about being more sensitive, more inward, roots. Okay, we want to keep our energy moving. So we do want to focus on good nutrition and rest and sleep, because dream time, like the time that we are sleeping and when we go into that dream state, is super replenishing for our bodies. And I will openly admit that sleep is like the one area that I get myself in trouble because I skimp. I love to stay up late and I also love to get up early, and that's like a bad combo. So it's so important as it starts getting dark earlier to start going to bed earlier and give yourself that opportunity to rest a little bit longer, because it does get lighter earlier in the morning. So it is kind of easier to get up earlier in the morning. I know it's colder maybe, but it's oftentimes it wakes you up early. So if you're going to bed late and you're waking up early, you're shorting yourself and you're not getting to replenish yourself as much as you could. So let's talk about sleep. Sleep is something that's so important, and some people have trouble falling asleep. Some people have trouble staying asleep. Like, there's all different types of sleep issues. So if you've ever had any, some people have like a newborn baby and you're being woken up by someone, right? Or someone next to you in bed that is snoring, or an animal that wakes you up, or whatever. We have all kinds of things that interrupt our sleep, but ideally, we want to go to bed like a couple hours before midnight, because that's when you get the most recharged and kind of rest is like during those hours before midnight. And we want to stay asleep, right? I mean, naturally we might wake up to use the bathroom or something, but we want to stay asleep and we want to sleep like around 8 hours. That's the goal. And I want to help you guys come up with some routines that help you wind down and stay asleep. So one thing that's really helpful is to read a book, right? Just to read something, not be on your phone, read something relaxing. Another thing is writing in a journal. You could use your gratitude oil that comes free this month with the November promos and write down like 10 things that you're grateful for. Kind of helps you let go of the stresses of the day and focus on something good right before you go to sleep. Another thing that's really fun is to take a bath. Young Living has all kinds of amazing oils and bath relaxation agents for us. So I want to share with you some of my favorite things. So I keep some Epsom salts in a jar like this. It just has a little cork top, but I also have mason jars that I just, you know, keep Epsom salts in. And what I'll do is I keep this next to my bathtub, and I take this off and I will take an oil like cedarwood or lavender or eucalyptus or anything that you feel drawn to. There are some oils that I would not use in the bath, like hot oils like oregano or thieves or something like that, that I wouldn't choose for a bath. But any kind of relaxation oil, peace and calming, valor, whatever you're drawn to, put a couple drops in here, shake it up a little bit, and then pour it into your bath as you are filling up the bathtub. So that's really fun. Another thing that I like to do is I like to take bubble baths. But I never used to take bubble baths because traditional bubble bath, like commercial bubble bath, is super toxic, right? So I use Evening Peace, and this is just the Young Living bath gel. And it is such a good bubble bath. There's also lavender, but you just like pour in like maybe even a capful or less, and you have the most amazing bubbly bubble bath. It's so fun. So give yourself an opportunity to take a bath. Like, pick one thing that you're gonna go do like tonight or in the next 24 hours. I think you should take a bath. I'm gonna take a bath tonight. Let's all take a bath tonight. And then Young Living just came out with the Dream Catcher bath bombs. So Dream Catcher is a super great sleep oil, but they just came out with these bath bombs with the holiday catalog, and they're still available. These have not sold out yet. So they smell incredible. You just drop it right in your bath and they dissolve, and it smells like Dream Catcher. There's no fragrance or anything yucky that you have to worry about. And then Young Living has bath bombs. So there's lavender and stress away, and they're just these little bath bombs which we love to drop in our bathtub, and they just, you know, get all foamy and smell amazing. So go take a bath. That's one thing that you can do to help you wind down to get ready to go to sleep. And when you're using those oils and you're feeling so comfortable and warm, that's just a very nurturing thing to do before you go to bed. And then other things to help with sleep, two supplements, Sleep Essence and ImmuPro. So these are two great supplements. If you are not a good sleeper or you need some help going to sleep or staying asleep, I would recommend trying one or the other or both. Everyone in our family swears by these. Actually, I don't take Sleep Essence, but Paul and Eli take Sleep Essence. I occasionally take ImmuPro. I go through phases of doing this one. This is chewable. It also is great for the immune system because it has wolfberry powder and some mushrooms, which are really great for immunity. And then it also has some melatonin, so it's helpful for sleep. So those are two supplements for sleep. Tranquil roll-on, my joke is that I call it tranquilizer. You can roll it on your wrist or your neck or have someone roll it along your spine, on your feet. Just calm down before you go to sleep. Other sleep oils that we love are Rutavala, Vetiver, Peace and Calming. I don't know, share if you guys have a sleep combo that you love, because sometimes it takes a little dialing in. Some people are like, lavender does it for me. Other people want to combine lavender with cedarwood, which is what this is. Lavender, cedarwood, and Roman chamomile is in Tranquil. So those are some sleep suggestions. Moving on, we are going to talk about the Chinese five element system. So I love learning more about the body as far as Chinese medicine goes, because there are lots of things that really resonate with me. So I'm gonna share with you what I've learned about that. Winter is related to the element of water. So there's all different elements, and each season has an element and different organs associated with it. So the bladder and the kidneys are the organs that should be supported in winter, and they're related to the element of water. So we're gonna talk about kidney and bladder. Has anyone ever had like kidney stones or a bladder infection or anything like with those organs? Those are things that are very common. And again, I'm not saying we're preventing or diagnosing or treating anything like that. We're just talking about supporting the kidney and the bladder, because this is the season where those organs need the most support. And funny enough, not funny, but today I like turned on my Instagram and someone that I follow was live talking about a bladder infection. And I was like, how interesting, poor girl, but how interesting that, you know, I'm talking about that right now and thinking about that. It's kind of fresh on my mind. And she was talking about having a bladder infection as we move into winter. So let's support these organs, and we're going to talk a little bit more about it. So winter power is deep and yin. So in Chinese medicine, they talk about yin and yang, or yin and yang, right? So the yin is the dark, the feminine. We're talking about yin in winter. So it's time to conserve energy and resources and not to be too outward or wasting our yang energy. That's more of like summertime, right? So we want to be kind of inward and relaxed and all of that. Water can also be related with the emotions. So we're going to talk about emotions in winter. So emotional balance, that it comes up when we talk about the kidneys, is fear. Okay, so with fear, you can also have anxiety. And there are two oils that you can use just right off the top of my head. There's probably several. And if you have other ones that you have used, please share. But according to Dr. Carolyn Mine, who wrote the book Releasing Emotional Patterns, who's familiar with Dr. Carolyn Mine and Releasing Emotional Patterns? We've done classes in here if you want to learn more about it, or you can get the book. But she says, to release anxiety, use joy oil. And the place on the body that she talks about using joy oil is right at the base of the ribs, below your solar plexus. So your solar plexus is kind of like right here, the base of your sternum. And a little bit below that, if you just kind of touch your ribs, this is the place where you could put joy oil to help let go of the emotional pattern, anxiety. And there's a little technique if you want to look more into it through the book, or you could just drop joy in your hands and breathe it and, you know, think about letting go of the anxiety. For fear, we use sandalwood, and the point is on the third eye. That helps us let go of fear, okay? So that's kind of fun, interesting, right? The emotions are related to water, and those are related to the organs. It's all connected. So the acupuncture system describes the circulation of energy in the body through a series of channels called meridians. So there's 12 different meridians related to all the different organs, and that's where the life force energy or the chi flows. And if there's a blockage in that energy, then that's when we can have problems, right? Pain or get sick or not feel good or whatever, physical and emotional. So the idea is to keep that life force and that energy flowing. And these meridians have 2 hours each day that they predominantly are circulating through the body. So for the bladder, it's from 3 to 5 p.m. And for the kidneys, it's from 5 to 7 p.m. So if you were going to really want to target those organs, you would want to focus on using the oils or working on the emotions or taking the supplements that supported those organs during that time of day. And if for some reason you were in a different season and it was in the middle of the night, they say to do the opposite time, so 12 hours before or after. But we can easily work on the kidneys and the bladder because 3 to 5 p.m. and 5 to 7 is when we're awake, right? So this is a 4-hour period of time where it's a transition time. That's when kids get out of school. That's when we, you know, typically get off work. It's when we transition into evening. So it's a time where we want to pay attention to how do we feel? Because someone who might have an imbalance in their water element or with these organs might get really emotional around that time of day or might feel really yucky during that time of day. That might be a time of day where you need to rest and relax. And maybe it's a time of day where we're pushing ourselves when we need to actually just kind of chill out and take our bath, right? So just some things to think about. When we think about water, we think about it being sort of having a rhythm or a cycle. Think about the tides. So you know how when there's a full moon, there's really extreme tides in the ocean? They're really low and they're really high when we have a full moon. The same things happens in our body. So we're affected by the moon and we're affected by other things. And sometimes we have like an excess of this water element in our body and sometimes we don't have enough. And that can affect the way we feel, it can affect those organs, it can affect our emotions. So the Chinese consider the bladder to be the storehouse of the emotions. Isn't that interesting? So we know about the center of the brain, we talk about the brain and the emotions, but the bladder is the storehouse of the emotions within the Chinese system. So if it's not functioning, then the rest of the system can be stressed and it can throw off the whole body. Now the bladder meridian begins at the side of the nose and goes up over the eye and it runs down the back of the body, like down both sides of the spine. So doing things like cat-cow and yoga or anything where you're moving your spine actually brings energy to that meridian, the bladder meridian, and helps it flow more freely. So just, you know, kind of stretching and moving and doing things that arch and contract your back can help get that energy flowing. So that's a simple way to bring energy into that system. Of course, having someone rub oils along your spine is a great place to bring energy along there too as well, if you can have somebody do that for you. And then that bladder runs down, the meridian runs down the side of the leg into to the side of the toe. So, you know, you could put oils along that side of your foot or something if you were working on your bladder, like on the pinky toe or the outside of your foot. Or you could look at, well, we'll talk about the Vitaflex points in a minute. So there is Vitaflex points on the feet. And the bladder Vitaflex point, I'm not gonna show my foot to you right now. It's on the inside of the heel, kind of at the bottom of the arch of the foot, inside of the heel. And there's like a little spot right there where you could stimulate and you can look that point up in your Vitaflex charts. You could stimulate that area if you really wanted to work on the bladder with an oil that supports the bladder, like geranium, juniper, sage, even valor, release, surrender, into the future, or forgiveness are all oils that help support the bladder. Now, I wanted to mention too that negative emotions, other negative emotions associated with the bladder are holding on to old ideas, fear of letting go, being pissed off, interesting, and positive emotions around the bladder are calm, relaxed, composed, and an affirmation we could say is, I let go of the past and welcome the new. Isn't that nice? So if you have anything going on with your bladder, you might have symptoms like pain around the pubic bone. You could even have dark circles under your eyes if you had something, or puffy eyes can be something going on in the bladder. Having pain or something when you're urinating, or having recent bladder or kidney infections. And obviously if you had anything serious, you would want to go get checked out by a doctor. But it's just interesting since we're talking about this time of year. And then there's a supplement that Young Living has, which is out of stock. It's been out of stock for a little while. It's called K&B, and that stands for kidney and bladder. So that's something that you could take or recommend to someone if they were working on strengthening their kidney and their bladder. But while it's out of stock, the herb that's in there, it's a mixture of herbs and essential oils. It's a tincture. And it has uva ursi, so you could take that separately from somewhere else. And then what oils you could use are juniper and parsley. So now we have parsley. It's a newer vitality oil that helps strengthen the kidney and the bladder. So you could use those until those come back, until that comes back in stock. So let's talk about the kidneys. The kidneys, closely related to the bladder, they help filter the blood and keep the body clean and balanced. And in the Chinese system, this is interesting, The kidneys are perceived as storing the energy of the life force itself. So in Chinese medicine, they say like the first place they look is the kidneys. If you're not feeling well, or if you have any kind of like chronic thing going on, chronic illness, they will look at the kidneys first. Isn't that interesting? I find that fascinating. So also, if we have rashes on our skin, oftentimes it can be related to something having to do with the kidney, because the kidneys and skin both work to clear water from the body in the form of urine and sweat. So if the kidneys aren't functioning properly and our skin is having to kind of pump out what the kidney's not keeping up with, we can get skin rashes. So I know a lot of times when you have something wrong with your skin, you're like, what can I put on this? I just want to make this go away. You know, you want to put something on the rash, which sometimes that is helpful. I mean, especially if it has to do with dry skin, but oftentimes there's something inside. We talk about that inside-outside balance. Like, yes, dry skin because the air is drier, but also why is it drier? Maybe, or why is it irritated? Maybe your skin is having to work too hard because your kidneys need a little support. So even adding those oils, just rubbing them on the soles of your feet, or I love juniper oil in the bath. I will put juniper oil with my bath salts and pour that in my bathtub. So that's a great one. Cypress oil is another good one. I'm gonna talk more about oils in a minute. So one of the main problems that with the kidney, or when the kidney is malfunctioning, is we're not getting enough water. Who feels like they don't get enough water? It's hard for me to get enough water. I mean, getting enough water is, you have to keep a water bottle with you all the time. And for me, I have to make water like taste different, because I'm just bored with water, straight up. I'm just like, ah, water, enough with it. So if you have not tried the Vitality Drops, there is lavender lemon, and this is my favorite. This is the grapefruit bergamot. And I just put a tiny bit, like a tiny, tiny bit in my water, my big water bottle, and it makes it so much more drinkable. And it has electrolytes in it, and it helps you stay more hydrated. So easy to do, but it makes such a big difference in making sure we're getting, I mean, they say if you're like 150 pounds, you should be drinking at least 8 8-ounce glasses of water a day. That's a lot of water. Like, that's a hard thing to do. I mean, for me, you could also do vitality oils, like any of the citrus oils, right? Lemon, grapefruit. What's your favorite vitality oil to put in water? Just a drop. And then after you've been using them for a while, right, we're like adding multiple drops. But that'll help us to keep our kidneys flushed out, so we don't have issues with our kidneys, especially in winter, since that's what we're working on. So there are a couple specific things about the kidney that I wanted to share. And the kidney has a reflex point that's on the side of the foot. You can look up the Vitaflex point. It's on the side of the bottom of the foot, kind of below the pinky toe, about right in the middle, but on the outside. And you could stimulate that kidney point with one of the oils that helps. So some of the oils that help with kidneys. Oh, hang on. Sorry. The kidney point is on the inside of the foot, not the outside. I was looking at the heart. So some of the oils that help with the kidneys are Valor, Into the Future, Surrender, such a great blend, Surrender, if you don't use Surrender, and Release, Inner Child, Forgiveness, Hope, Humility, Juniper, Sage, and Geranium are all great. So a lot of the same oils as the bladder, right? They're kind of overlapping. So those are all oils that you could use, and it's on the inside, the middle of the foot. There's a little spot kind of on the inner arch, right in the middle between the heel and the big toe, and you could stimulate that point. Or just rub oils all over the soles of your feet. If you don't want to look up the Vitaflex point, or that's not interesting or easy for you, just rub oils all over the soles of the feet, put them in your bath, rub them on your lower abdomen. So the kidneys lie kind of on the lower back, the soft tissue in our lower back, so you could rub right where your hands kind of reach your lower back above your sacrum on each side. Rub oils there, or over your bladder, like your lower abdomen right above your pubic bone, or places that you could rub these different oils if you're wanting to bring some support there. So negative emotions associated with the kidney are fear of the future, disappointment, criticism, failure, shame, stuck, and revenge. And then positive emotions associated with the kidney are moving forward, faith, love, safety, approval, and success. And an affirmation for bringing balance to the kidneys is, I enjoy new things, I look forward to the next adventure. So moving forward. And the time of day for the kidneys is 5 to 7 p.m. So that would be a time of day where you could use one of these oils or take your bath or work on the affirmation. So if your kidneys need support or they're out of balance, you might notice pain in your mid-back, dark circles under the eyes or puffy eyes, a history of kidney stones, your urine could have like blood in it or a strong odor. And if you have skin eruptions, psoriasis, or eczema, it might actually be because of the kidneys. So also it relates to blood pressure and edema or swelling. So fun information about the kidneys. Let's talk and let me know if you have any questions. I'll come back later and answer them in the comments. So let's talk about winter diet. So we know that the weather is getting colder and we need to stay warm. So it's a nice time to start thinking about warming foods. It is not a good time of year to do like a radical cleanse or go on some diet because, I mean, if you need to go on a diet because of a specific, you know, instruction from a doctor and you're under care for that, listen to them obviously, but it's not a great time to do a cleanse because our bodies need to be warm. They don't want to be in starvation mode, and that can actually lead to gaining more weight. A better time of year to do a cleanse is in the spring, right? When it starts to warm up and we can eat more raw and fresh foods and be warmer, that's a better time to work on cleansing. And there's lots of different protocols about cleansing all of the organs and when to do which organs in a really great book called Inner Transformations with Essential Oils and by Deirdreff. And it talks about how to cleanse the liver and when, how to cleanse the intestines and when with Young Living products and with dietary things. So if you're a cleanser, you want more information on that, you can check out there. But during these cold months, we want to conserve all the energy that we can. So we don't really do cleanses now. So since winter is colder, we need to adjust our diet to foods that produce more heat. And we want to look at things like root vegetables and squashes. I just bought this big old butternut squash. So I will wash this, I will peel it, and I will cut it up into chunks. There are some seeds inside. You just scrape them out. It's almost like a pumpkin. And you can put them on a baking sheet and sprinkle it with like a little bit of, you could make a mixture of avocado oil or olive oil, whatever kind of oil you like to cook with, and add a drop of black pepper. It's really strong, so you might want to start with a toothpick dip, but you could do like salt and pepper or veggie salt or whatever you do to season it, and then kind of sprinkle it over the cubes of butternut squash and put that in the oven and roast it. And it's such a good little side dish with whatever you're having. So that's a fun, like super easy recipe, is like roasted root vegetables. And root vegetables are really nourishing for the root chakra, the bladder, the kidneys. We're thinking about the roots, and that helps us to stay warm and stay nourished. All the vitamins and minerals that are down in the earth that get absorbed into these root vegetables are really important for us, especially in winter. So carrots, turnips, yams, onions, garlic, anything that grows under the ground, we want more of right now. And it's better to have things cooked and sauteed in a little bit of butter or ghee or coconut oil or whatever you use to cook your veggies, or steamed, roasted, anything warm, more than having salads and raw fruits and things like that. We want to have things that are more cooked because that's more nourishing. And then grains. I eat grains and I'm a fan of grains. I know some people choose to do no grains and that's totally fine. But grains, especially like quinoa and millet and even buckwheat, are super nourishing. Whole grains are great for the intestines. They're good for your health. And when you combine them with like black beans or pinto beans, adduki beans, lentils, they make a complete protein. So super healthy to have grains and beans and a vegetable. Super filling, super nourishing. You can use your vitality oils to spice them up a little bit. You can use ginger and cayenne and garlic and onion, you know, just make it flavorful and good. And other things that are great for a winter diet are seaweed. So kelp and nori and different types of sea vegetables are really nutritious. And they're helpful for our body because they're high protein and they're high mineral and vitamins that we don't get from food that's on the earth, right? So the ocean has different minerals that we don't get. So any kind of sea vegetables, and if you eat fish, fish is also has different minerals that can be good for us too, if that's something you eat. And in Ayurveda, they even recommend cooking your fruit. So I have a recipe in here I think I posted the recipe. I know I posted in this group about a fruit compote, and it's so good. So there's just all different fruits, and you cook them, and you add different spices to them, and that's really nourishing, especially for certain body compositions. And there's a whole separate class on Ayurveda. If you want to search this group, search in little search bar for Ayurveda, and there's a whole class on that. But consider cooking your fruits and having them warm. And it's much healthier to use sea salt rather than table salt. It's just more nourishing for your body if you are salting things to flavor your food. Of course, exercise like walking and yoga or Pilates or weights or whatever you do to move your body is important to generate that heat and to stay warm, right? I love going for a walk this time of year and I get home and I'm all warm, you know, whereas otherwise I feel kind of cold, especially my hands and feet. So keep your joints flexible. It's important to keep our joints flexible. So lots of stretching and things like that are good in winter. And herbs like marshmallow root and ginger root. So ginger root, you can chop up fresh ginger root or marshmallow root. I've gotten dried before, like from suppliers online or herb stores. And you can boil water with these roots, just ginger or marshmallow and ginger, and you can kind of simmer them for a little while, like maybe 15 to 30 minutes, and have that be a tea. It's like a really yummy tea. Add a little bit of raw honey, and it's just very nourishing and warming. Ginger is very warming for the body. It's spicy, so I don't know how spicy you like it, but you can do more or less ginger depending on how spicy you like it. And they're great for the kidney and the bladder, specifically marshmallow root and ginger. And then you can add a vitality oil. Ooh, I have some tea right here. I have some warm tea. In my Young Living mug. And you could add a vitality oil like Thieves, because it's got the cinnamon and the clove, right? Super warming, and you can add that in there just to bump the immune supporting up a little more and to make it taste different or taste fun. And now Young Living has these awesome, so spiced turmeric is my favorite herbal tea. And so it has a lot of these warming things in it that we're talking about that are really supportive. This came free last month. The month before? I don't remember. I think it was last month. But if you didn't get it for free as a promo, you can order the tea. And so ginger is the first ingredient. There's cinnamon bark, rooibos, fennel, black pepper, turmeric, sarsaparilla. So super yummy way to nourish your body is drinking warm tea and then add a drop of whatever vitality oils you like just to support yourself even more or make it taste different. It's really fun way to get your nutrition in with herbal teas. And then I shared a recipe. I have a recipe in this group, and then I shared on my Facebook wall, which I made the post public, so you can go look at it even if we're not Facebook friends, or send me a request if we're not, and on Instagram, Colonna Giuliano, just my name, for turmeric latte or golden milk. And it's such a good recipe. It uses this Young Living tea. You could use any tea. And then I have the recipe and you can add oils or you can just use like, you know, the cinnamon powder that you have, turmeric powder. And then it's fun to kind of add like black pepper oil or cinnamon bark oil or nutmeg, whatever you have. Start with a toothpick dip because a whole drop in one cup of tea with like something like cinnamon or nutmeg, it might be too strong. So start with just putting a toothpick in the top and kind of getting a little swirl, and then you could work your way up from there. But super nutritious, tasty, and super good for our immune system. So some other things that I really like outside of like supporting our bladder and our kidneys, which we talked a ton about, a couple staples. I always take Life 9 probiotics. This is just a staple every night before bed. I take one or two Life 9 probiotics because that just supports healthy bacteria in our gut, which is where we really need to stay healthy all year round. So that's something that I always do. If you really need to bump up your immunity, you've been around somebody sick, you're gonna be traveling on a plane or maybe exposed to someone who has something or just out in public more or something, do Inner Defense. This supplement is really strong. They are filled with oils. So it does have some coconut oil in it, but then it also has the Thieves Blend plus, what else is in here besides the Thieves Blend? My eyes are not so good, lemongrass. So there's lemongrass and oregano are the other two oils besides thieves. These are powerhouse. Like, make sure you have food in your stomach if you haven't tried these before. And then opposite time of day, you will take Life 9 probiotics to replenish the healthy bacteria. Another good immune support, just general all around, is vitamin D. Even if you're in the sun a lot, you probably need more vitamin D, and now Young Living has vitamin D. So that's super helpful all the time supplement. And then respiratory support. So the oils that we know, that we love, that come in the kit, we have Raven. The other one is RC, super helpful for respiratory support and just staying healthy, opening up our lungs and being able to breathe well before we exercise or even before we go to sleep or when we're gonna, you know, meditate or do yoga. Anytime we're gonna be like using our breath or anytime, it's just important to be supporting our respiratory system. So RC stands for respiratory comfort. Really great. This is the first blend that Gary Young ever created, and it's super powerful. So I would get some of that and have it on hand, and you could alternate it. I love frankincense. I think frankincense is a must-have. Super powerhouse for the immune system. Great for the emotions. The other secret weapon is Exodus 2. Exodus 2 is a very powerful blend for the immune system to alternate with thieves. I know most of us use thieves on a regular basis. I drop it under my tongue, we rub it on our feet, put it in our tea. There's all these different ways we use thieves, which is great, but I think it's good to change it up, and it's important to have something else. So if you don't use Exodus 2, this is a really good one to rub on the soles of your feet or however you wanna use it. Take deep breaths of it, dilute it and put it on your chest, but rub it along your spine. Exodus 2 is super powerhouse. So, lozenges, the other thing, are thieves' lozenges, thieves' cough drops. Those are must-haves, like all year round, but especially in winter when it's drier and your throat, you know, needs some extra support. Traveling, wearing under your mask, like I keep lozenges in my purse all the time. So to stay balanced in winter, little recap, we wanna stay warm, we wanna keep quiet, we wanna sleep well, we wanna be at home, we wanna eat those nurturing, warming foods, and pay attention, look within, and pay attention to keeping our emotions balanced. So I know that was a lot. Let me know if you have any questions. I hope that that is super helpful for keeping all of us really healthy. We can keep each other accountable and maybe use this thread to comment when we take our bath or when we make some tea or roast some vegetables or make a fruit compote or something like that. We can keep bumping this post and remind each other that to keep those practices up so we can stay healthy as we move into winter. All right, guys, thank you so much for being here and joining me. I'm so grateful for you. I'm grateful for this community, and I just love all of you. So thank you very much. Stay healthy, and I will see you later. Bye.